So Livermorium was first made in around 2000. It was made in a calcium 48 plus curium 248 reaction. We've since made four different isotopes of Livermorium. They all have tens of millisecond half-lives, so they're pretty short-lived. So unfortunately, I can't show you a bottle. It was a very interesting process to name these elements. When we got permission to name 114 and 116, we were naming two elements at once. We, of course, began discussions with our Russian colleagues and reached a consensus on these names, Flerovium for 114 and Livermorium for 116. We chose Livermorium because we could not discover enough elements to name one after everybody who was important in these kinds of experiments. There were many, many scientists here at Livermore. Some had retired, even passed away, who were involved in heavy element research. So we couldn't discover enough elements to name after every single person. So we chose Livermorium to honor all those people, honor the institution here and the city of Livermore. We thought that was an appropriate way to kind of recognize all of those scientists involved in that work.
You spend some time in the community. I know you talk at schools and obviously you know people. How has that decision been received by the institution and the people of Livermore? They must be over the moon.
It's been outstanding. The mayor of Livermore is a water chemist, so he understands chemistry. He was ecstatic that this came about. He understood the significance of a new element and that particular name on the periodic table. He's been very supportive. We have a Livermorium Day now, which is in late May. They've also named a part of a park, a plaza in downtown Livermore, Livermorium Plaza. So they've been very supportive, very ecstatic about it, and understand. I think this community here, because the lab is here, you know, it's people are scientifically understanding or scientifically literate, so they understand the significance of it. So it's been nothing but supportive for that element. So one of the predicted properties, because it's in group 16, it's in this column of the periodic table where many of the hydrogen compounds of that group are very smelly. So think about hydrogen sulfide, the rotten eggs smell. Hydrogen selenide.
Oh, selenium.
Yeah, selenium is notorious for being very smelly. Rotten garlic or something like that is described as telluride. The telluride tellurium is also very smelly. So if you think about the going down that a column of the periodic table, you might say that Livermorium is maybe the smelliest element on the periodic table. It would be very difficult to verify because we haven't made the hydrogen compound of it. The isotopes, as I mentioned, are 10 millisecond long, so it's very difficult. And in addition, you probably wouldn't want to smell it because it's radioactive and you wouldn't want to actually put your nose on and smell it. Hydrogen sulfide won't hurt you. It'll hurt you in, you know, strong enough concentrations, but everyone smelled rotten eggs before. You wouldn't want to do that with Livermorium.
So let's keep going and see where the experiment is. So as we go along here, the ions are going faster and faster and faster all the time inside the tube.
Here you see such a target wheel, which is mounted on the axis of this motor here. It's like this in the beam.